My daughter, Shannon, is 15 years old, and she was diagnosed with Phelan-McDermid syndrome at 6 months or so of age. And although very few people have heard of it, it is a rare condition that can cause autism, epilepsy, intellectual disabilities, and because it's so rare, we have no treatments. In 2000, when she was diagnosed, she was the 35th case in publication. Currently, at 2016, we estimate there are 1,400 diagnosed cases in the world. There's a lot of undiagnosed cases. If everybody with autism or intellectual disabilities were referred to genetic testing, which is the only way to diagnose this condition, then there would be probably 8,000 to 10,000 cases in the world. Getting a diagnosis for this condition was difficult. In my case, I was fortunate to live in a great medical community around Washington, D.C., and I had fantastic providers who recommended genetic testing early. My day-to-day routine was turned upside down upon diagnosis. I had a 5-year-old and a 3-year-old, typical sons, and my daughter suddenly had specialists in several states, and we were constantly going to doctors and therapists and pharmacists. That wore on the family. I would not have been able to hold down a full-time job due to the time that was needed. I mean, it's a very rewarding position to be in charge of Shannon's life, but it can be very exhausting. The Phelan-McDermid Syndrome International Registry is a collection of names and contact information, but we wanted to go beyond that. We wanted to collect what the researchers needed and couldn't afford or didn't have the time to collect themselves. You will hear from the NIH, FDA, researchers around the world that natural history studies are imperative to finding treatments for rare diseases. And by that I mean you need to see that patient not just once or twice, but over a time span. So in our registry, the patients will answer their 300 questions, and then we encourage them to go back annually to update that information. And so it then becomes what they call a longitudinal study, where they're collecting data over time, and you can watch the progression of the disease. The registry is really a great jumping off point of identifying the characteristics of a disease and following it through time.